Hey guys, what is going on? In this video, we're talking about that orange teal look that you see everywhere. We're gonna explain what the reason is behind the orange teal look and how you can achieve it in your videos. All right, so the orange teal look is typically what you see in like big blockbuster films. It's definitely become more and more popular, and the name comes from its look. The colors are pushed into the oranges and the teals. So to understand why this look has become so popular, we have to look at color theory. If you look on a color wheel, basically the orange teal look comes from complementary colors. It's contrast in a scene. So instead of being contrast in terms of light versus darks, you're looking at color contrast. And the color contrast comes from the teals and the oranges because they're on separate sides of a color chart. So a question that you might have is, why do we only see the orange teal look out of this idea of contrasting colors? And one of the main things you have to think about is skin tones. If we were to use a different complementary look from the color chart, a different style of contrast, you're gonna throw the skin tones way out of whack. Skin tones naturally fall more in the orange category. So you wanna make sure that your skin tones look good, because that is the first thing that's gonna make your film look awful, is when the skin tones are pushed so far in a direction that they turn green or super red. It will pull you out of the film and you'll start thinking that there's something wrong with what it is that you're watching. So the first thing you have to think about is making sure that your skin tones are natural. So to contrast your skin tones, which are in the orange, the rest of the image needs to look more teal. And so that's where we come up with this theory of the orange teal look. You have a contrast in colors. They're on separate sides of the color chart. And when you put them in a video, the highlights, the skin tones, all that becomes more orange, and the background and all the darks in the image will become more teal. And so when you really push this and you stretch it to the extreme, you get that orange teal look. Now there's different variances of this look. You don't have to go super over the top, but one film in particular that really stands out to me was the new Mad Max film. You could see that they went orange and teal, and that's like the entire film. They are like a complete definition of the orange teal look. Most of the image is either orange or teal, and there's no other colors in these frames. So when you apply this look to one of your own video clips, you'll see that the skin tones will start to pop and the subject in your video will start becoming more of a focus. And because this look is being used all the time in big blockbuster films, it's now being defined as like the cinematic look. So that's why you see YouTubers, that's why you see Instagrammers, you see everyone producing content that has this orange teal look to it. Even in my office here, I've created a background that has that kind of orange teal look already built into it. You can see the image I chose over here is more blues and teals, and the one up there is more reds and oranges. So you have naturally that orange teal look in the background, even if you guys didn't realize it. Okay, so let's get into how you would achieve this look in any editing software. There's a couple ways that you could go about color grading. You can do it natively in your color grading software. If you're in Premiere, if you're in Final Cut, there's different tools that allow you to push the colors around. The other way is to use LUTs. And what a LUT is a lookup table. And a lookup table basically is like a mathematical equation that is applied to your footage to interpret how the footage is stretched on the color wheel, or in editing terms, your vector scope. So one of the tools that you have in all your editing softwares is a vector scope. And essentially what that is a color wheel that you could see the layout of all your colors. And it's a great tool to use to be able to understand how this orange teal look is achieved and to see how to push your image around in terms of color. So let's pull up a screenshot from Mad Max and I can really show you how the colors are stretched on the vector scope. So you can see here that it's a very straight line from the oranges to the teals, and there is no other color in this image. Basically, everything is squashed into that line between those two colors. And the further you go out from the center on a vector scope, the more saturation you have. So the orange teal look really pops when you put a lot of saturation in it, and that's how you can see on this vector scope how far it's pulled apart. Now let me show you a screenshot just straight from my camera. So this is a shot in Vietnam, and this is just of a street. you could see how it's more of just a blob in the center of my vector scope. Just right there in the center, that's all the colors. Now, if you're going to edit just natively in your editing software, you use your color wheels and you have your highlights, your mids, and your darks, and you could play with your saturation. Now, as we start pulling these around, you could see how you start manipulating the vector scope and start pulling your colors more into the teals and the oranges. Now, the issue when you're doing this in your editing software is that as you start pulling these colors around, you're gonna start creating these color casts on your image, and it doesn't have that same orange teal look that you typically see in a lot of these blockbuster films or these big YouTubers. And I know it could get frustrating when you're editing in this style because you know what you're looking for. You're trying to pull the colors into that orange and teal. You're gonna pull them further and further and you're gonna boost your saturation, but all you're gonna do is create this crazy kind of color cast on your image. It doesn't look like what you're trying to achieve. So that's where a lookup table comes in. And I'm gonna show you just in a software called 3D Lut Creator. This is what I use to create all my LUTs. When you pull an image into your 3D LUT Creator, you basically can manipulate the vector scope so that your colors only work in a certain defined area. So I'm showing you 3D LUT Creator just to show you what a LUT typically does. You don't need to understand 3D LUT Creator to be able to use LUTs. There are so many LUTs available out there. You can just buy a set of LUTs or find a free set of LUTs and you can use them for your footage. So what you do is find a LUT that you want to use that has the orange teal look. And what you do is you can drop that on your footage and it automatically does the set of instructions so that your colors push into the orange and teal. And then from here, as with any LUT, you need to do a little tweaking because no LUT is perfect for the footage that you have. LUTs in general are a set of instructions that give you a predefined look, but from there, what you need to do is go through, play with your contrast, play with the colors a little bit more to get it to where you want. But you wouldn't be doing these huge sweeping movements that you were trying to do when you were color grading the original footage. So you still have that really defined orange teal look created from the LUT, but then you can manipulate it a little bit to make it work for your footage. So here is a little sequence that I put together from my footage in Vietnam. I'm gonna show you both sides, unedited and edited, using an orange teal LUT that I created. And I'm really gonna push this into the extremes so you can see the color contrast and how much it makes a difference to have that orange teal look. All right, guys, if you have any other questions about using LUTs, color grading, or just the orange teal look in general, please let me know in the comments below. If you're curious on how to apply LUTs in your specific software, every software has different tools to allow you to add LUTs. In Final Cut, there is a preset called Custom LUT, and all you have to do is drop that on your footage, go into your settings, find the LUT on your desktop or wherever it is on your computer, and it will auto-apply that LUT to the footage, and from there you do a little color grading. In other editing softwares, there's gonna be something very similar. So just do a quick Google search, look for how to add LUT in whatever software that you're using, and there's so much information on the internet that there'll be a set of instructions on how to apply a LUT in your specific software. All right, guys, that is it. I hope this explained what the orange teal look is and why you're seeing this look kind of everywhere on the web, Instagram, YouTube, but why everyone's just using this color look in general. But guys, if you're new to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. There's a lot of awesome filmmaking tutorials. I've got a lot of just awesome stuff on this channel, and I've got some pretty cool stuff coming up this summer. I'm working on some pretty big things. Also, make sure you come find me on Instagram at Jeven Dovey. Shoot me a message if you have any questions. I'm happy to help you out with any of your filmmaking needs. All right, guys, that is it. I will see you on the next one.